Hello and welcome to a, what is this? Is it a walkabout? Are we walking anywhere?
This is a workshop update. We're not walking too far, it's raining.
Too far. Yeah, it's Burglow.
We've got a few things to tell you about anyway.
Yeah, fine. So, update from Pendre, and we have some three things we're going to focus on today, which is locos, loos, and carriages. We'll start with locos, because Chris knows something about that. And we've had a swap around, Chris, haven't we?
We have.
We have.
Number two's gone to Aberystwyth, to the Vale of Ido Railway, for purposes of setting the valves. Because when they did the work on the crank axle, they found that the two of the eccentrics were in the wrong place. An eccentric has to be set on the axle in the right place because it drives the valve, and it's quite important for the timing. So the easiest thing was to send it to there on a hired lorry, where they've got a crane and space and all that, and the fella works there that knows all about valve setting. So that's good, because it creates now a space in the workshop, and number one's here. And as you notice, number one is now back on its wheels. It's been around on a industrial unit for a year or so. But the axle boxes have been machined. There was one of these videos, Bob Millard told you all about how he did the axle boxes. So it's now been reassembled, and Bob was back the other week. He's working for us again, which is great. So it's back on its wheels, as you can see. We've got buffer beams here. You wouldn't believe it, but a steam engine has got a wooden buffer beam because it's so old, it's 1864. So the old ones were cracked and damaged and split. So we've got, these are the two new buffer beams. Well, we've had to route out these square holes for the square bolts to go through. This is actually the back, and you see the front on that side.
What wood's this then?
This is a hardwood, this is oak. We've had it in stock for 20 years or so, I think.
Really?
Waiting to use it. Yeah, it's been in an old shed for a long time.
This should be nice and
nicely seasoned.
Nicely seasoned, yeah.
That's it, yeah. This is a laser cut. This plate you'll probably recognise from the front. The old one was made of checker plate and slightly damaged and distorted, so we've had a new one laser cut by Model Engineers Laser, who we use for a lot of things. So that's brilliant. These can now go back on. The buffers are here, so we'll be able to actually shunt it around the site.
So the boiler of this is still down south.
Down south, mid-ant, yep.
Yeah. But that's been progressed.
Yep, they'll be getting the tubes in it soon, and the main steam pipe and some studs, and we're putting a flange on the top for a new manifold as well.
Right.
But the mid-ant railway staff are working on it as volunteers in their own premises, because they are also volunteers on Talyllyn.
So big thank you to Midhouse.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're nice people down there.
Yeah, they are. Brilliant. Good
they're
railway.
So nice, we send Chris there quite often, just as a little treat for them.
Come and visit it, that's
so, yep. When number two comes back, is it coming back in here then?
Two will come back in here.
This will get shunted back
in. This will have to be moved probably over to the north shed.
Yeah.
And the focus then will be putting the boiler on two and all the bodywork and putting it back together and getting it back in traffic.
So that's a pretty swift process.
I think so.
Process-ish.
Yeah, all the hard work's done on two. We need to hydraulic the boiler, and then it's a straightforward assembly job. So we're hoping to get that done reasonably soon.
That comes back in lovely TR bronze green.
That's what our bosses have decided.
And
yep.
But
we can't moan about our bosses with liveries, because we've got some good news, haven't we?
But new number one is going to be coming back in
Great Eastern Blue.
Great Eastern Blue. Wouldn't
that be nice? That suggestion's come from one of the workshop staff, and the council and the board have all agreed with it. So it's a very dark blue with some nice lining on it, and it should look really nice, we hope. We've already bought the paint, so.
It's never been that colour before.
No, and something new.
I don't think we've ever had a TIAG in that colour, but it's something different, and it's nice to have something different in the fleet. I quite like green, but it's nice to have a little bit of variation. Obviously,
yeah.
At the moment, we've got number six in RF blue, and that will change when that comes out, and that's out next end of 23
year after next
2024
that's it.
Is.
That's anyway, it.
We know what we're talking about, don't we, Chris?
He's got a book that tells him. So yes, it's not authentic, but it's something new, and
that'll get the wibble factor up, won't it?
I think it'll look nice. It's only paint, it's not the end of the world.
So it's only rust prevention, isn't it? That's what we say.
So two will be done reasonably soon, and then one will come back in to occupy our only pit in the workshop to be put back together when the boiler comes back.
Cool.
So that's brilliant.
Cool.
Yep. So unfortunately we lost the industrial unit, but there are pluses. This fabrication table was made by Martin Turner, and we've ripped out our old welding bone and put it, this table in its place, which offers a lot of advantages. We can get a 6x4 sheet on it, we can lift the curtain up and put a long article through the middle. It's flat and square. The lighting's good, although we're going to put it on an arm that goes over the top. So that's a distinct improvement. And the articles on it are a batch of screw couplings that we're making, because a lot of ours are worn out. So these are new screws and nuts. And if you try and twiddle that, there's absolutely no play in that, which is how you want it when it's new. We are inspecting them all, the existing ones, and we clamp them to the bench and attempt to move the screw in the nut and measure it with a dial test indicator, just to get a measure of how worn they actually are. But we've got a few that we've condemned by that basis. But this is the final stages of a batch, which we've had the screws and nuts made, but we've made all the other stuff ourselves. So they're the shackles that are being welded together, and there's a big pile of them there. So it's something that's unseen, but it's really important.
What, not coming apart?
You can't have trains coming apart, no. Certainly not. No.
It's never a good day in the office.
No, that's it, yeah.
Well, I'm glad you boys are excited about the new bench. You have low bar, isn't it?
Hey.
Right, so we've got everything that's green is working, and everything that's not is not. Is that the easy way to update the local plan?
Yeah, that's it, yeah. Yeah, that's fair enough.
So what's up with this one?
This one is the first one to be stripped for the annual boiler exam, which you have to do every winter, where you take out these boiler plugs, which is a taper, BSP tapered thread. These are bronze, are screwed into the boiler. So these are all withdrawn, and that enables the boiler inspector to have a good look inside for any corrosion or stays that have necked.
He's put a little camera in there or something, does he?
Yeah, he's got a little endoscope camera. So they all come out, and the boiler's washed out of any sludge or anything like that that's in there. So as I say, this is the first one to be done. You also have to inspect the firebox inside. So being a narrow gauge engine, our full-size people don't fit through the fire hole.
So we need some narrow gauge people, do we?
Yeah. So we have to take the ash pan off. And if you have a look down there, the ash pan has been dropped down underneath into the pit, and the boiler inspector can get up inside. Same as a traction engine, I would imagine. So this is the first one to be done. So you won't see this in service at Christmas, unfortunately. But during the winter, we've got working parties. There's a couple of working parties to do the annual exam work, so it's a stripping, cleaning, and then putting back together. And Chris Parrott, who's up the end beavering around, he's a key fellow on that as well. So volunteers are wanted for the annual exams on the engines. We'd also like some volunteers for the outdoor working week in November, which is, I think, the second week of November. The third week of November, we've got the S&T week, where a lot of signal and telephone maintenance is done, which is quite interesting. And then the last week we've got Tree Week, where we do a lot of tree maintenance. We want chainsaw operators and people to do labouring associated with that. So there's quite a lot of work coming up over the winter.
Cool. Okay, so that's a good update of that. So sort of linking into outdoor and S&T, we've installed some facilities at two of the block posts, which we've been needing for quite a while.
So we're here at Bryn Glas with my colleague Jeff, to announce the opening of our new composting and urine diverting toilets that are situated at Bryn Glas and at Quarry Sidings. These are brilliant toilets that will separate out solid waste and urine, and that means that we can compost the solid waste and the urine goes into the soakaway. So it's all natural, it's brilliant, they're permanent, so we're not worrying about portable toilets anymore. So Jeff, would you like to do the honours and cut the toilet roll ribbon?
I am delighted. I'm honoured, in actual fact, to be able to use, having spent many an occasion here crossing my legs tightly, to declare the marvellous establishment well and truly open. Oh, look at that reading material too. This is delightful. A place that I shall spend many, many happy hours.
We come in here a lot, don't we? Because it's always warm and dry.
And good lighting.
And we always like an update of the what's going on in here. So it's always exciting stuff, because it's always nice and shiny and bright and
clean.
It's clean.
Nice new things that are being built.
New things.
Like the open coach.
So the last time we had an open update, there was only one buffer on, but we now got four buffers.
Four buffers on, and the draw hook.
A draw hook. You've got brake cylinders on. Yep. And there's other stuff happening with the gubbins.
Yep, there's an air
Help
tank
me out,
on.
Chris.
The brake pull rods and the linkage have been laser cut by Model Engineers Laser. They'll be here this week. And we've got some 60mm bar on order for the bosses to weld onto the ends of them. The step board has been sourced and cut and painted, and that's ready to be drilled and go on that side.
That's only one side. Of course, it's only,
you only
one
have
side.
A step board
only
one side. Yeah,
one set of doors.
One set
there?
Of doors, one side. Yeah, okay. And this door lock has now been assembled and looks quite good. This is a recovered handle off of a Mark 1 coach, which we got from the Scottish Railway Preservation Society up at Bowness. So that's the operation of the door. With the handle vertical, won't open, which is the feature that we all wanted. And you have to do that, obviously, to open the door. So.
Right.
That's good.
But and more exciting inside.
More exciting inside. We've got a seat that's being built. These laser cut ends with the tabs welded on. Are secured to this frame, which has also been made, and the frame's bolted to the body there. So we have to put it in and spot through, then take these down to the machine in the workshop and then drill them. We'll have wooden slats, which are somewhere, and they all go between all the tabs. So it's not quite a nice curve. It's going to be more comfortable than the older opens, which are just a plank of wood. So that sort of curve follows the old Chorus coach. So that's quite nice. So that's coming on.
And then behind
and over there, we've got a new item of rolling stock, which we've bravely picked the colour ourselves. And this is the trailer for the Toby trolley.
Why is it not yellow then?
Toby's green, isn't he?
Oh, Toby.
Toby. Okay, Toby's green, yeah.
All right, so what's this going to carry then?
This can carry tools, a cable drum for laying cables,
yeah.
Or a water tank in the summer for firefighting.
So it should be red then.
So it'll be, yeah, so it'll make Toby a lot more useful. Martin Turner made it around the unit over a weekend, I think, so
okay,
didn't take
fine.
Quite a nice job. I hope it's not wet.
Does it need a number then?
Hey?
Does it need a number?
Yeah, all our trolleys have got numbers.
Wow.
Starting with T, because a trolley ran away on a steam railway a few years back. And there was no maintenance records for it, so
okay.
All our trolleys are numbered and they have an annual
so,
inspection.
So will this be braked?
No,
no,
no brakes, but okay. Permanently coupled with a drawbar.
Okay, fine. Cool. So that's the update in here, and I suppose that leads on to the other carriages, and we have had discussion about one of our carriages that hasn't been around for quite a long time, and a lot of members will know that Lulu has languished up at Quarry Siding for too long. And the reason why is because we haven't got the space to jack it up. And this is one of the only places you can jack it up, isn't it, in here?
That's right, yeah.
And if it gets jacked up in here, we lose the whole thing again for a prolonged period of time. So we've decided that it's going to have a little holiday and probably in Aberystwyth and get fettled down there. So that's progress for people that like our historic coaches. And hopefully by next season, we'll have a full rake of the original TRs back in service. That's the plan, isn't it?
Yeah, that's reasonable. Yep, it's been a while since it was off its wheels, so we are expecting a lot of arising work that's discovered once it's lifted. So we didn't want to jack it up in the workshop or here because it's going to occupy space for quite a long time, we thought, and it would scupper a lot of our other projects.
Yeah. So yeah.
Sending it away is, on that occasion,
and
makes
also
sense.
Talking of Aberystwyth, who's got number two at the minute, and then we'll have Lulu, is also what we're getting done by them.
They're building us a ballast hopper. We've sent the bogies down. They are ex-Bowwaters bogies, which are pretty rusty, but otherwise not too bad. And they're going to build us a bogie ballast hopper, which will improve safety. At the moment, we've got these tiny little four-wheel ballast hoppers. Not all of them are braked, and you have to walk alongside them to dispense the ballast, where a bogie one, you can stand on the platform on the end in better safety, really, and operate the hand wheels, and it will carry a full lorry load of ballast as well, which is 20 tonnes, I think. So that'll be a distinct improvement.
Okay. That's exciting stuff, isn't it?
Yeah, it's all going on.
It really is.
Yeah.
That is a big progress thing. So, there's a lot going on between us and the Vale of Rydal, and there's a lot going on here. So you've got plenty of time in the winter to get it sorted, haven't you?
Hopefully, yep.
We run daily until the 6th of November. And then we have a little break during November, and then we come back. As Chris said, we've got lots of outdoor weeks, so people can come and help. But during December, then we start running trains again. We've got tinsel and turkey, so if you want to have a steam train ride and fill your belly, that's not staff, by the way, Chris.
We've got the staff Christmas do. He's letting us have a staff Christmas do this year. That's good.
Tinsel and turkeys for Tuesdays in December, plus Santa specials, plus festive steam between Christmas and New Year when you're fed up with the teeth of sitting around eating Quality Street. So lots going on. It's all on the website. I've just updated it this morning, so I know it is. And come and see us. It's the best time to travel is the winter, I say. See you soon.
Cheers. Thank you.